Lawyers at DeNittis, Osefchen and Zimmerman law offices, which represented the customers, did not immediately respond to similar requests. The litigation began after Australian teenager Matt Corby in January 2013 posted a Facebook photo showing a footlong sandwich he bought was only 11 inches long, not 12. But a prominent class action critic, Ted Frank, said this merely codified practices Subway adopted soon after Corby's photo went viral. He said it made no sense to award $520,000 to the customer's lawyers, plus $5,000 of incentive awards to 10 plaintiffs, for settling. Subway has acknowledged that the media frenzy helped drive its decision to settle. But Sykes noted that short sandwiches contained no less food by weight, and that even now some sandwiches might be shorter than advertised. The settlement acknowledges as much when it says that uniformity in bread length is impossible due to the natural variability of the bread baking process, Sykes wrote. Contempt as a remedy to enforce a worthless settlement is itself worthless, she added. 0 + 0 = 0. This is exactly the opinion we were hoping for, Frank said in an interview. It affirms the principle that when attorneys bring class actions to benefit only themselves, it's an abuse of the system, and courts should not tolerate it.